Do you have any wisdom that you impart to the troops and how to deal with it?
The players?
Yeah.
No, not really. You know, I think they know. They know the drill this time of year. You know, I can tell you it's nicer going into this time of year, you know, in a playoff spot, in the spot we're in, than, you know, where I've been in previous years, you know, scratching, you know, from the outside, looking in, you know, trying to sell, you know, the hope that if we can get on a little bit of a run this time of year, maybe we won't be, you know, dumping salary, we might be adding, you know, those were tough situations to be in the last couple of years prior to getting here.
Can it be a distraction for players? Or?
Sure can. Yeah, absolutely. I think both ways. You know, obviously when you're coaching a team that might be selling, you know, anytime guys have to or start to think about, you know, am I going to be moving? What about my wife? What about my kids? And, you know, and it's the same thing on teams where you have guys and they might be adding someone. You know, there's always a potential someone would have to leave if you bring somebody in. So it's a distracting time of year, but these guys are pros. They've for the most part all been through it before, and they know the drill. Stuff you can't control.
What did you think of Bayou last night?
First game? I thought he gave us some good energy. You know, he's he hops over the boards. He's got great speed. You know, when he's on the ice, he plays a forecheck game, which is you know, the style we're trying to play. It's nice to have, you know, the ability to have those type of guys in the organization to bring in and out.
What can you even say at this point about what you're seeing from Covey right now?
Well, he's taken his game to another level, as have all our, you know, I talked coming out of the deadline that, you know, we have a group with a history, the veterans of being able to raise their level at this time of year and into the playoffs. And I think as a group, they're doing that. Kobe, Zach, Marty, Patrick, you know, across the board. So that's what we need.
Do you find, is he sort of setting a tone as far as really just playing well and getting others to follow, or is it really coming from a lot of different places?
I think it's coming from a lot of different places. I mean, obviously he's a key guy for us, but you know, we're getting that type of effort from all our leaders, and you know, if they do that, everyone else follows.
Can you say anything about the Zilicki?
No. First thing I read about it this morning. So.
You have no history?
No.
Socorro okay?
Yeah, he's resting today.
Any chance you'll have Larson by the end of the week, or is that still slow going?
I think it's, I would term his recovery slow moving, but in a positive direction. So again, there's nothing structurally wrong. It's just a stiffness, soreness, you know, that type of stuff. So I can't answer that. So, you know, he could wake up tomorrow and feel great. You know, he might not.
He's still been skating lightly or whatever.
Yeah.
Were you impressed with the D-Core? I mean, as far as losing two guys like that,
yeah,
just continuing to...
Yeah, you know, they've come in, and I think as a group we buckled down defensively. You know, out of necessity, when you lose, you know, two of your arguably top four defensemen, and Larson and Talinder. You know, they've really done a good job of, as a six-man unit, of playing a safe, simple game, you know, and really, I think, being hard to play against as a six-man unit.